on Bitrise, a lot of people can work together on a single app or on multiple apps. People can form teams and organizations to effectively use Bitrise together. Let's take a look at what teams and organizations are. Every app on Bitrise has its own team, which you can check out on the app's team tab. To be able to work on the app in any way, a user must be added to the app's team. The app's team is made up of individual users and groups. And of course, if you add an app, you automatically become a member of the app's team. Let's say you have a small app. You are doing okay on your own, but you'd like some additional help, so you want to invite a colleague. That's easy. To add an individual user, just go to the app's team tab and scroll down to the add users to the app window. Or just click the add member button. It will take you there. Type in the username or the email address of the user you want to add to the app and select their role. What are those roles? The roles govern what a contributor or a group has access to on a Bitrise app. For the rights of the different roles, you can always simply click on the role cheat sheet on the app's team tab. For example, as you can see here, a developer can run builds but cannot modify workflows, while a tester QA user can only view builds so that they are aware if a build succeeded or failed. For now, let's select developer. Now we've added a single person to an app's team. What if we want, say, every Android developer at our company to be able to run builds on our apps? What if we want to assign all of them to the same app at the same time as a group? To do that in a simple and convenient way, you need an organization account. An organization is a special type of Bitrise account that can include an unlimited amount of members working on unlimited amount of different apps. Organization accounts are separate from individual accounts. To sign up for an organization plan, you need to log into an individual account, create a new organization, and sign up for our standard or elite plan. Let's do that now. After logging in, go to the account settings page. On the left, scroll down to the organization section and click the new organization button. Name your organization and set a billing email. Don't worry, this can be changed later. To be able to start builds with an organization account, you need to provide payment info as well, but we'll skip it for now. On next screen, you can transfer apps from your own account to the new organization. But again, you can do this later. We'll just transfer this one app for now. Now you can invite people to your new organization. Go to the Groups menu. Groups are the backbones of organizations. To be a member of the organization, you have to be a member of one of the groups. Of the four default groups, the most important is the Organization Owners group. Only organization owners can create new groups and add people to the existing groups, as well as manage billing. We created this organization, so, by default, we are the owners. As owner, you can add and remove owners. The only rule is that the organization must have at least one owner at all times. Now, as you can see, there are three other groups by default. They are named after the different roles you can have on an app's team. But don't worry about that. Their names don't matter. You can assign them whatever roles you want. And you don't have to use these groups. You can rename them if you like, delete them, or just ignore them. Let's do that for now. Let's create our own group. Just go to the Create New Group option and enter the group name. Let's call it the A Team. And then click Create. Now let's invite some users to the group. Click the Enter Email Address or Username field. Here, you can add a new user from outside the organization or from one of the existing members of the organization. Just type in the username or email address of the user you want to invite, or click the name in the list below. What can our new group do? As of now, nothing. Organization groups simply serve to group people together, nothing more. What those groups do is up to two things: what apps they are assigned to, what roles they are assigned on the app's team. Let's assign our new group to some of our organization's apps. There are two ways to do this. If you want to add the same group to multiple apps, the best way is to go to the Groups page, click the ellipsis to the right of the group's name, find the app or apps you need. You can search for them in the search field at the top, and click on the little plus sign next to them. Select a role, and click Done. Now, if you want to add multiple groups to the same app, the best way is to go to the app's Team tab and scroll down to the Add a Group menu. Here, you will see every single group of your organization that has at least one member. Click on the little plus sign next to the groups you need, select their roles, and click Grant Access. The same group can have different roles across multiple apps, just like the same individual user can have different roles across multiple apps. Find a setup that best suits your needs. Feel free to leave a comment below. If you want to be an expert, check out the whole playlist for the topic, link in the description below.